I'll explain here how to process a telephoto composite sequence from a solar eclipse using Photoshop. Make sure you shoot in RAW. The photographing procedure is similar to the wide-angle image. Shoot a series of images during the partial phases and totality. You'll need to have the solar filter on during the partial phases and off during totality. I set the remote intervalometer to shoot a frame every minute during the partial phases. You can then select an interval from this group. See the video link for a presentation on photographing a total solar eclipse. Depending on the focal length, you'll have to make adjustments every 7 to 12 minutes or so. In this example, I was using a lens at 600 millimeters and adjusting the framing every 7 minutes. For the purposes of the composite, the crescent sun doesn't need to be in the center of the frame. Like the wide-angle composite, select an interval between the partial phases and select a set of frames before and after totality. In this sample, the interval is about 20 minutes between frames during the partial phases. Pick one good totality photo with much of the corona showing. You can also include the diamond ring Bailey's beads image if you wish. Put copies of the partial phases, frames, totality, diamond ring, and Bailey's bead frames in a separate folder. For this example, I'll just use the partial and total phases. Adjust the brightness of the partial phases so they match. Open the totality file in Photoshop. Look at the pixel dimension in the lower left corner of the desktop and remember those numbers. In this example, the frame dimension is 7,360 by 4,912 pixels. In Photoshop, create a new canvas by going to File, New. The dimensions depend on how big your camera's file sizes are and how big the sun moon is in the frame. A good rule of thumb is to double or triple the pixel width of the file you open and use those numbers for the canvas dimensions. You can also do the same with the height of the file. In this example, I will make it wider and use 20,000 by 10,000 pixels. Resolution should be the same as your camera files, 300 in this case. Color mode is RGB color, 8 bits. The background content is black. Then click Create. You'll see this large rectangular blank canvas open up. It will make a pretty big canvas, but you may end up cropping this. You can open up all the files you need for the composite, or just one at a time. I have all the files open here. If it's not already open, go to Window, Layers, to open the Layers window. On my desktop, that shows up in the lower right-hand corner. Select the corona photo. That will be the center image. Go to Select All, or you can use Control A or Command A as a shortcut. Then Edit, Copy. You can also use Control C or Command C. Select a new canvas tab named Untitled 1 in this example. Go to Edit, Paste. Or Control V, Command V. The corona photo will appear on the canvas. You will also see a layer appear as layer 1 in the layers window in the lower right hand corner. And that is above background, which is the canvas you created, the blank canvas. Select the Move tool in the toolbar that's at the top. With layer 1 selected in the gray, you can use the arrow keys to position the corona in the center of the canvas. You can also use the mouse to make large movements, but you could also use the arrow key to make very fine movements. go to View, Show, and Grid. This will produce a grid over the image that is temporary, and it will help you align the various suns in the image. To adjust the grid size, go to Edit, Preferences, Grid, Guides, Grids, and Slices. I changed the grid line number to 300 to create a coarser grid. Click OK. I zoom in on the image and line up the sun moon disk along one of the horizontal lines and on or between the vertical grid lines. I'll zoom out. And it doesn't have to be completely precise. If that looks pretty much in the center, then that should work. Select the next frame. It's easiest to choose a frame that is closest to totality, a thin crescent, and then go work your way out to the edge of the canvas with frames that show more and more of the sun. Select, copy, and paste as described previously. At first, you'll just see the crescent sun, which what you should do now is hold your shift key down. The layer 2 should be selected. Hold the shift key down and click on layer 1, and you'll get both layers selected. Go to the blending mode window, pull down menu, which usually says normal. Choose lighten. You should see both images now. Click on layer 2, go to the image, click near the crescent sun, and you should be able to move that sun with the arrow keys. You can zoom in for more precision and position the sun so it's along that horizontal line. You can roughly make a check the distance between each of the suns. You could always go back later and make some changes. And you do this for all the subsequent pictures. I'll select and copy and paste it. So now you have 3 layers. We'll have to select all of the layers. Go back to Lighten. Select layer 3 now. That often appears in different locations. So you click on the image and you should be able to move third layer over to the left-hand side. I'll zoom in to make it a little bit easier. So I'll place the sun on the horizontal line, about the same distance apart as the other sun. Repeat this for all the partial eclipse photos, any diamond ring or Bailey's beads frames on both sides of the corona image. You can also undo the grid to check your work every once in a while. You'll soon have a sequence of the eclipse progression, and the layers window will have a group of layers. Hide the grid to check your work. If you need to make adjustments to the position of a particular sun, click on the layer, use the arrow key to adjust. At this point, I would recommend saving this entire file with the layers as a TIFF file, even though it's quite large. The TIFF will save all of the layers, and you can return to make any adjustments or changes to the positioning or even the brightness of each of the suns. If you're satisfied, then you can go to Layer, Flatten Image. This flattens or combines all the layers into one image, so it'll be much smaller. You can now crop the photo if needed. You can resize and save it as a JPEG. For the April 8th, 2024 total eclipse, I recommend a maximum focal length of 500 to 550 millimeters on a full frame camera to avoid cutting off parts of the corona during totality. This composite sequin image doesn't require a long telephoto image. Pictures from a 200 or 300 millimeter lens will work just as well.